Chanel.
Natalia.
Okay, did you share your coming out story?
My coming out story.
Listen, I don't know if I like girls. I like, I'm curious. I'm tri-curious. I want to try, but I'm scared. Okay. So that's my coming out story.
Okay.
I'm going to sum it up like this, like, I'm adopted, and so the way my family was, I really didn't get to come out until later, you know, in my adulthood, but now my family loves me.
Gucci. Jessica. Cheyenne. I got to think about it. I want to say it's probably my college life. But my family already knew, like, they're like, okay, nothing's new, like, your Barbies had a girlfriend, so we gotta figure it out. So it was an easy transition coming out, everyone was accepting, so.
Yeah, it was actually, like, my senior year in high school, and I basically told my parents, but they kind of figured it already. No one had any problems with it. I mean, my dad's family wasn't really too happy, but they got over it.
My name is Galaxy. I was in the seventh grade and in a small town in Florida, and I had enough of trying to be like everybody else. I knew I was different in kindergarten. And I came out to my school first in seventh grade, and everybody else spread the message about me. And then in 10th grade, I came out to my family, and I wrote my dad a letter, put it in his car, and never left the school. And I grew up Jehovah's Witness. So it wasn't such an easy coming out story, but not very well. He didn't mention it for 3 weeks, and I was like nervous. I was like, oh shit, 3 weeks. 3 weeks went by. I was like, did he get the letter? But I mean, now it's turned out good with my family. Yeah, but it wasn't taken well then. There was a lot of resistance.
Oh, you're having more.
I'm Emmanuel Alvarez.
I'm Nick.
Jackson.
John.
And how do y'all identify?
I'm pretty gay myself.
Gay.
Gay as well.
Gay as hell.
Okay, gay as hell. Would you like to share your coming out story?
Sure, why not? Okay, so I actually, what I did is I got home and I was like, you know what, I'm kind of tired of like dancing around it, and I'm kind of tired of like not telling my parents. So I went upstairs and I was like, Mom, will you come like sit on the bed with me really quick? And she was like, okay, sure, what's up? And I was really, really fucked. I was like super nervous. But we just kind of talked for a minute. And then I was like, listen, I want to tell you something. And I know that you might not like it, because like we had actually talked about it before. And my sister had actually come out to her like a year before that. And she kind of didn't take it awesome. But anyway, we were sitting in the bed together and I was like, hey, so I'm gay and I just wanted you to know. And she cried a little bit, but like, she actually said that she was glad that I finally told her who I actually was, because she didn't really want me hiding from her. So that was, yeah, that's how that happened. I cried a lot too, but it was a good night, because I just feel free, you know, it's better. Yeah, thank you.
Mine was very different. I didn't tell my mom that I liked boys until a guy came to the door and picked me up. And I just kind of told her that Taylor was coming to grab me, and she didn't know if it was a girl or a guy, but it was a guy. But she kind of knew I was fruity my whole life, because she asked me from the time I was 9. But then one time she asked if I was gay, and I was like, yeah, I'm pretty sure, you know, I've decided, I think I like men. And she kind of got mad that I didn't come out earlier. She was kind of upset that I didn't tell her earlier in life. She thought I was lying to her, but really I didn't know. So I just had to inform her.
I went off to college and I started being openly gay there, and then I came back home and I got tired of the feeling of hiding and walking around in a secret, so I finally decided to take my mom into the bedroom and sit her down and tell her that I was gay, and she took it as best as she could. She's very old-fashioned, so, but it's going well.
Mine was interesting. My younger brother actually came out before me. He was in like fifth grade. And so I decided that the next day I was just gonna bring a guy home. And I thought that was all right. That was not really good, but it was cool.
Yeah.
It worked.
Got the point across.
It got the point across. So that was it.
Eric.
Eric, what's your, how do you identify?
I'm gay, they come.
Would you like to share your coming out story?
I guess it's not that interesting. I was in the car, and I looked over to my friend and I was like, hey, I like boys. And then I was too nervous to tell my other friend in the car, and I was like, do you mind telling him? And she was like, sure. So that was that. But I mean, it is what it is.
Have you come out to your parents?
Oh yeah, my mom loves it. She loves the gays.
Okay, cool.
Colton, Samuel. My mom found my porn. She already knew. And I was like, I'm gay, I like dick. It's okay, you know. I'm gonna, that's just what I like. My parents didn't care, so it wasn't that big of a deal for me.
Yeah, mine's just new, like she asked me, I just said yeah.
That was easy.
Yeah, like it was pretty basic.
Hunter.
Dylan.
Sloppy.
It's a little complicated, you know, parents and all. But I was kind of outed, so I didn't have a choice. So that's mine.
My mom basically saw a comment that I made on my ex-girlfriend's Facebook, because she said that, she said something about God was crying today because gay marriage was legalized in North Carolina, and I commented under it and basically like educated her and everything, and my mom came in and saw the comment and she asked me about it, and I just went through it.
So after Proposition 8 in California, I grew up Mormon, so after that I kind of came out as a defiance to my mom being a Mormon and supporting Proposition 8. So we just kind of went from there, and now we get along, but it's not a great relationship.
Sure. I was married, I am widowed, I have 3 adult children, and they did not know about me. I met him, we started dating, he has 3 children, he's widowed, and he had told his children that it would go over well, and it gave me the courage to come out to my kids.
I came out to my family, and I decided to come out to my mom first because she likes to blab, and I figured she'd let everybody else in the family know, and that way I wouldn't have to keep repeating, you know, that I was gay, and they've been really good about it, accepting. My kids have been accepting.
How long have you been together?
7 years.
I am a gay male.
Coming out story?
Whenever I was 12 with my dad, it was a lot of emotions and tears. He didn't accept me at first. Thankfully, I got lucky and he accepts me now. But with my mom, it was just a, oh, honey, I knew. It took you so long. She just took it right from me.
And did you first met?
This is my first time coming to Pride, yeah.
Are you from South?
I'm actually from Hickory.
Join the South?
I am.
Awesome. Thank you.
No problem.
Darian. So I don't really have a coming out story. I pretty much just like text my mom. I was like, hey, my girlfriend's gonna be coming home with me for Easter. And then that was pretty much just that.
Mine's kind of traumatic. So I was dating this girl in high school, and my dad had asked me about it, and I said no, said no. Long story short, he like got really mad, like wanted to kick me out. That's pretty bad. He tried to punch me, and then my mom came and got me or whatever, and like I live with my mom. My mom supports it or whatever. And later on, my dad was like, it is what it is. Like, we just kind of didn't talk about it. But then like the rest of my family totally supports it. And I mean, there's a lot of people out there that go through like the same kind of like worst of mine. People just parents just totally like don't even accept them. That's terrible.
My name is Courtney.
My name is Denisha.
So, I don't think I really have a coming out story. I've just kind of always been gay. So, yes, for a little while, I was in heels and dresses and wigs. So, kind of was giving for them. One day, it came up in conversation. I was just like, yeah, I'm gay. And they're like, okay, cool.
Well, my coming out story is a little different. I actually would sneak and steal my aunt's clothing and wigs and stuff like that. And I actually, how everybody found out was, everybody already had speculation because I've always been feminine, but I snuck out the house, dressed up one night, ended up getting into a fight. And when the police came, they had to take me home to my mom, well, actually my grandmother, dressed in drag. So, woohoo! That's how everybody found out. It's a mess, but everything, you know, happens for a reason, and it became a beautiful thing with, you know, everybody finding out and come to grips with it.
I'm on my way, can't stop me now. You can do the same, yeah. What have you done today to make you feel proud? So what?